wherever you are. Now let I go again.
You are my love. I will sing praises unto my God while I have any being. Put not your trust in princes, Lord, nor in the Son of Man, in whom there is no help.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It says, praise him, all my soul. Praise him, the Lord.
Mon âme loue l'éternel.
David said, I will praise the Lord with my dying breath. Hallelujah. First of all, when we talk of praises, what is praises? What do we mean by praises? Because some of us, when we talk of praises, we just think and dance. That is not all about it. He said, praise is an act of expression, respect, and gratitude.
De gratitude
to God,
à Dieu,
for his goodness,
par rapport à sa bonté,
for his glory,
par rapport à sa gloire,
giving thanks to him,
donnez-lui le remerciement,
telling God how mighty he is,
à l'éternel comment
telling
il est,
him how faithful he is,
dis-lui comment il est,
telling him how wonderful he is,
comment il est merveilleux.
That is what we call praise.
C'est ça ce qu'on appelle louer.
Praise doesn't mean you just come and sing and dance. There is something deep inside
you. Chanter et danser.
And why do we praise God?
Est-ce que nous louons vraiment l'Éternel?
We praise God to call for the attention of His glory.
Quand nous le louons, c'est pour appeler son attention par rapport à sa gloire.
We praise God to show forth His glory.
C'est pour montrer sa gloire.
The Bible says He has created us.
La Bible dit qu'il nous a créé.
He created human beings.
Il a créé les
so that they might show forth His glory.
Montrer l'avancement de sa
so
gloire.
So that they might praise Him.
Pour qu'ils le louent.
So that they might show the people that he is God. They can make people know that there is somebody that is above every other person. The Bible says when he delivered the children of
Israel
from the land of
Egypt,
from the exile, he delivered them so that they can show forth his praises. He delivered it so that the people can see the hand of God upon the life of the children of Israel. Same goes to us today. When the Lord saves us out of situation, when He saves us out of difficulties, He is saving us so that people can see His greatness upon our lives. So that people can see His hand upon our lives. It's not because of anything. So much more we think that it's because we are so righteous. It's because we are so faithful. That is why when we are in situation, the Lord steps us out of that situation. No, it's not because of that. It's because He is God. It's because He has promised never to fail us. It's because He has promised never to abandon us. It's because He has promised to never be with us, to deliver us in that situation. That is why He is saving us out of situation. Not because of our righteousness, not because of our holiness, not because of who we are, but because of who He is, and because of His promises upon our lives.
Hallelujah.
We must place value on praises. There are times when they are praising God here. You see people sitting down. If you know what it means to praise God, when you look at the life of David, the Bible says when the Spirit of the Lord came upon David, David was praising God. He does something. His life that he was tying on his face had to fall down. And the wife was mocking at him, said, look at you. But he never mind. He kept on praising his God. Because he knows who his God is. Because he knows the God that he
serves.
When we praise God, when you have value, when you know the essence of praising God, you will not praise God in sin. You will not praise God in sin. You will not come out of a fornication bed to come and praise God. You will not come out from stealing money to come and praise God. You will not come out from gossiping to come and praise God. You will not come out from lying and envy to come and praise God. No, my brothers and sisters, we need to place value on praising God. You praise God with purity.
Nous allons le louer avec pureté.
You praise God with a pure heart, with a pure conscience, so that when you stand before the Lord, you will know that, yes, this is my daughter. You will know that I have found somebody like my servant
Job.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You will not praise God.
Tu ne vas pas louer l'Éternel.
Why you are just coming from gossiping one sister or one brother?
Tu commérages.
Because we are good at that.
Parce que nous sommes très
God doesn't please. He's not pleased with that. When you come and you stand and you are praising God after doing all those things,
l'Éternel.
He will just look at you and smile and say, "Look at this one." After gossiping, you come and praise him. After committing fornication and adultery, you come and praise him. Who are you?
He and you.
We need to praise God in purity.
Nous allons le louer dans la pureté.
We need to praise God in holiness.
Nous allons le louer quand nous sommes saints.
Praising God is an option. It's an obligation. It's not an option. It's a must. For the human being to praise God. You don't take it as an option. Can anybody want to sing this thing? Anybody want to praise God should praise God. It's an obligation. Because God has created us for us to praise Him, for us to exalt His name, for us to glorify His name, for us to show forth His glory unto the people of the nation. So it cannot be an option.
Ça ne peut pas être une option.
It's obligation that we all may save God. Because in one way or the other,
d'une façon
God has been good to us.
Le Seigneur est
in one way or the other,
d'une façon
God has been faithful to us. In one way or the other,
d'une façon
God has been so kind to us. In one way or the other, He has provided for us. He has met our needs. He has healed us. He has saved our families from calamity. So it's an obligation for us to praise God. It's a must for us to serve Him. It's a must for us to praise Him with all our hearts, with all our soul, with all our mind. You don't need to praise God only with your mouth.
Tu ne dois pas seulement le louer de ta bouche.
You need to praise God with your soul.
Tu dois le louer de tout ton âme.
We need to praise God deep inside us.
Nous allons le louer du profond.
Let God know that you are praising Him.
Il faut le laisser savoir.
Because if we just come and praise God, we just flash that we are praising God. If you are praising God, it doesn't come deep inside you.
Si tu le
if you are not doing it with your mind, if you are not doing it with your soul,
si tu ne fais pas de ton âme,
that is not praises.
Ne fais pas louer l'Éternel.
You are just wasting your time.
Tu es en train de perdre ton temps.
You are wasting your time.
Tu es en train de perdre ton temps.
That is why David says, David make a vow that he is going to praise God all the days of his life. No matter what he is going through, you don't praise God only when things are going on well. You don't praise God only when God bless you with money. You don't praise God only when God bless you with a child. You don't praise God only when God give you right to pay. You praise God even on your sick bed.
Tu dois le louer même durant ta maladie.
You praise God even if you don't have food to eat.
Même si tu n'as pas de quoi manger.
You praise God even if you don't have a dress to wear.
Même si tu n'as pas de quoi te.
You praise God even if you don't have a husband or a wife. Because when you praise God in that situation, that is when God begins to provide for you. That is when God begins to make way for you. That is when God begins to answer those prayers that have been asking for a long time. We should not only be happy when things are going on good.
That's why
you have to come to church and say, God, I bless you. God, I exalt your name. But when things are going on wrong, you just see even others are praising God. You say, my God, I cannot serve that God again. I cannot praise Him again. I have been praying and He has not been answered. I have sat for a long time without a husband, without a wife, without a child. Then my God has not answered me. Why should I praise Him? Praise Him in that situation. And that is when the breakthrough will come.
Si tu le loues dans cette situation, c'est là où tu trouveras le bonheur.
Don't let the devil mock at you.
Ne laisse pas le diable se moquer de toi.
Don't let the devil take advantage of you.
Ne laisse pas le diable prendre l'avantage de toi.
Because when you are praising God,
parce que quand tu le loues,
the devil will come and see, oh, even in this situation, this man still has the grace to praise God. Even though I have not given him, God has not answered his prayers. After 10 years, she or he still have the grace to praise God. Yes, then the devil says that. Because there is a breakthrough in that. There is an open door in that. When you told them, the devil will be afraid of you. And at times, he will be afraid to even come closer to you. He will know that this one, no, is one of me. This one is untouchable. This one is not a place to go around. Hallelujah. Yeah. And when you keep on talking that way, God has done so much for us.
Il a beaucoup fait pour
that even if some of the prayers are not yet answered,
même si
they will be answered at the right time.
Ils seront reconduits plus tard.
It's not every prayer that God answered at the same time. There are prayers that the Bible says weeping may tarry for a night. But joy comes in the morning. He said the devil cannot let you live, but he cannot deny. What God has planned for you, the devil cannot take it away from you. Even if it lasts for 20 years, my brothers and sisters, it might come to pass. Even if it's 100 years, it might come to pass. When the Lord promised Abraham a child, the child didn't just come at once. It took some time. The promises was delayed.
La promesse était
but finally,
finalement,
it came to pass. So why can't we follow the steps of Abraham?
Que tu ne peux pas suivre les pas d'Abraham?
He was not bothered.
Il ne s'est
because he knows his God. Most of us bothered because we don't know the God that we serve. Most of us bothered because we don't know that we are serving the God that is able. Most of us bothered because we don't know that God never fails.
Le Seigneur ne déçoit pas.
That is why we bother too much.
C'est la raison pour laquelle nous nous plaignons beaucoup.
That is why we worry ourselves too much.
C'est la raison pour laquelle nous nous dérangeons
when situation arises.
Nous sommes dans des situations.
That is why we keep up.
C'est la raison pour laquelle
when it's almost time to our breakthrough.
Quand c'est au moment opportun.
That is why we surrender to the devil.
C'est la raison pour laquelle nous abandonnons au diable.
When it's almost time to our breakthrough.
Quand c'est juste au moment opportun.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We need to serve our God.
Nous devons servir notre Dieu.
We need to praise Him.
Nous devons
let praise be an attitude.
Que la louange soit une attitude.
Let it be an attitude.
Que ce,
something that you have developed. Something that you always sing and say, glory be unto you, God. You always sing and say, God, I exalt your name. You always sing and say, God, I bless you. You always sing and remember what God has done for you and praise Him. Let it be an attitude.
Que ce soit une attitude.
Let it be inside you.
Que ce soit dans
because God. When you make praise an attitude,
quand tu fais de la louange une attitude,
there will not be a time
il n'y aura pas de temps
that you sit and think over your situation.
Que tu penseras
because when some situation arise, and you just think of, oh Lord, you are good, Lord, you are kind. Before you realize it's God,
cette situation passera.
But when you don't make praise and attitude, when you see that situation arise, you start thinking over that situation. You start lamenting over the situation. You start crying over it.
Tu dois pleurer par rapport à la situation.
It's good to make praise and attitude.
C'est bien de faire de la louange.
There are times some of us have situations.
Parfois, nous avons des situations.
This one is more than me. I cannot bear it anymore. I cannot carry it anymore. You see, you are thinking and you are paying and you are going. But by the time you just raise a song of praise, by the time you just sing one melody unto the Lord, by the time you sing one hymn unto God, you see the thought is disappeared.
Tu vois cette situation disparaître.
It's gone.
C'est Dieu.
It's gone. And when it's gone, it's gone.
Et quand c'est parti, c'est parti.
Because each time it comes, you will raise presence.
À chaque moment où cela va revenir,
and it will be difficult for you to think.
Ce sera difficile pour toi de penser.
It will be difficult for you to lament over situation.
It
will be difficult for you to cry over situation.
C'est difficile pour toi de pleurer devant cette situation.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when you are praising God, you need to develop that attitude of being patient.
Cette attitude d'être patient.
We always have to be patient.
Nous devons tous être patients.
Because some of us, why praising the God will stay God? I've been praising you for a long time.
Ça fait longtemps que je suis en train de te louer.
So all my praises are in vain. There is no praises to God that is in vain. We just need to be patient. The problem is with most of us is just that we are not patient. We want to run faster than our shadow. We want to go before God's time. But it's impossible. What you want at that particular moment?
Qu'est-ce que tu veux en ce moment particulier?
You have been praying over it. Maybe God has seen that if I give this child this day,
le Seigneur dit que si on
ne le fait pas, tu ne and God will tell you, wait, it's not the right time.
Il va te demander d'attendre.
You cannot take $1 million and give to
$1 million et donner à Fervor d'arrêter aujourd'hui.
No. That is why we need to be patient.
C'est la raison pour laquelle nous devons être patients.
We need to wait on God's time.
Nous devons attendre le temps de Dieu.
We need to wait on God's time.
Nous devons attendre le temps de Dieu.
Hallelujah. Reasons to praise God.
Nous devons louer l'Éternel. Les raisons pour louer l'Éternel.
Number one reason to praise God.
La première raison.
Reason to praise God is an act of dependency to God.
C'est un acte indépendant de Dieu.
When you praise God,
quand tu loues l'Éternel,
it shows that you are depending on God.
Ça montre que tu dépends de Dieu.
That's why the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5.
La Bible dit dans Proverbes chapitre 3.
Trust you in the Lord and
crois en moi
with all thy heart and lean not on your own understanding. Trust in the Lord. Depend on Him alone.
Dépend en lui, rien qu'en lui.
Depending on God is an act of praising God. When you depend on Him alone, making God know that He is in control of your life. Making
him
to know that the life that you are living is not your life.
Pas,
making God to know that no matter the challenges, no matter the ups and downs, you are still dependent on Him. You are still dependent on Him. You are still trusting in Him. Thank you for
n'abandonne pas.
Always depend on Him.
Il faut toujours dépendre.
Don't look left and right.
Ne regarde ni à gauche ni à droite.
That's why Peter almost sinned.
C'est la raison pour
laquelle he was looking left and right.
C'est parce qu'il regardait toujours à gauche.
He never knew that there was somebody
in that land. Il ne savait pas qu'il y a quelqu'un sur qui il peut compter.
Depend on your God.
Il faut dépendre de ton Dieu.
No matter what the devil tells you,
peu importe ce
no matter how the devil torments you,
peu importe
don't turn away from God.
Il ne faut pas te tourner contre Dieu.
Don't move a step backwards.
Il ne faut pas aller en arrière.
Just lean on to God.
Il faut t'accrocher sur
just
lui.
Depend on Him.
Il faut dépendre de lui.
And He will see you through.
Et il te verra au
and He will save you.
Et il va te sauver.
But when you start looking around left and right from where to go, say, may I go to this Baba? May I lean on this my uncle? May I lean on this my auntie? That is when you start thinking. That is when you lost your trust and dependency on God.
Que tu perds ta conscience.
But when you just trust and depend on
God, you cry,
the right time will come.
Au moment opportun,
the moment will come.
Le moment viendra.
He says, those that depend on me will never be put to shame.
De moi ne peuvent être jamais.
You will never be put to shame when you depend on God.
Tu ne seras jamais déçu si tu crois en Dieu.
God will never disappoint you when you depend on Him.
Il ne peut pas te
décevoir. God will never fail you when you depend on Him.
Il ne peut pas te décevoir si tu crois en lui.
God will never abandon you.
Il ne peut jamais t'abandonner si tu dépends de lui.
When you depend on Him. Hallelujah. Number two reason to praise God.
La deuxième raison pour louer l'Éternel.
Praise is to acknowledge God's greatness.
C'est pour montrer la grâce de Dieu.
So maybe can you read Ephesians 3 verse 20?
Ephésiens 3.
Ephesians 3:20.
Now, unto Him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly, above all we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us.
Hallelujah. He said, unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly. When you acknowledge the fact that God is able,
can't you?
When you acknowledge that fact,
can't you?
That he is able to do.
He is capable to do
everything.
Do.
That is able to provide abundantly for you. That is able to supply your needs.
Il est capable de supplier toutes tes besoins.
When you acknowledge that fact,
quand tu acceptes cela,
you always praise him. When you know that there is somebody there,
quand tu connais
that when everybody abandons you,
même si
he is always there for you.
Il est toujours là pour toi.
When you acknowledge the fact that
quand tu acceptes
even
cela,
your mother that gave birth to you rejects you when you needed
your
most, he is always there for you.
Il est toujours là pour toi.
When you acknowledge that fact,
quand tu acceptes
even when you are in a country without document and not have been protecting you,
dans un pays et tu n'as personne,
you know
tu
that he is there.
He
to protect
là,
you,
il est là pour te
to save you,
pour te sauver.
No matter what, yeah. We just need to acknowledge our God.
Tu dois seulement accepter ton Dieu.
No matter if your friends are in school and you are at home, because you don't have things to pay,
still
acknowledge him that he is a God that is able. He is a God that can do what no man can do. He is a God that can supply our needs. He is a God that can pick us out of a lion's den and bring us out. Acknowledge that fact.
Il faut accepter cela.
Because the more we acknowledge him, the more we tell him how great he is. The more we tell him how marvelous he is. The more we tell him how beautiful he is. The more he blesses us. The more he does great things in our life. The more he provides for us. But when you don't acknowledge your God,
accept the part of you,
what did you expect?
Qu'est-ce que tu
attends? Even if it's human being. When somebody has been doing something to you every time, do you expect that person to keep on giving?
Tu crois que cette personne
no, you will get tired. But when he is giving an each time, you are, oh, can you? Oh, you are so good. You are so kind. You give him the grace. You motivate him to do more. Same goes to our God.
La même chose va à notre Dieu.
We motivate God by giving all the sweetness. By acknowledging the things that he has done.
Yes.
Because when you acknowledge the ones that he has done, it will
come. Tu acceptes que quelqu'un a fait pour toi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Number three. Praises take our mind off our problems and shortcomings and help us to focus on God. Praise the Lord. It takes our mind off our shortcomings.
Ça prend notre conscience plus loin.
And focus it on God.
Et ça nous met, ça nous fait nous concentrer à Dieu.
121 verse 1 to 2.
Psalm 121.
I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. Where is coming my help? My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth.
Hallelujah. Amen. He said, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills of where cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. When you are praising God, you don't think of the things that are going on around you. You don't look around what is going on in the world. You don't look around the situation that are going on all over the world. But you focus on him alone. You look for him alone. The service is look unto my God from where my help coming from. Man cannot help you the way you're going to help. Man can help you at the time they give up. At the time they will take their pass on you. But your God cannot turn his back on you. Your God cannot fail you. Your God, when you look unto him, he makes sure he provides for you. He makes sure he sees you through those difficult moments. He makes sure he solves that situation for you.
Il résout cette situation pour toi.
But when you look up to man,
mais quand tu regardes en long,
you waste your time.
Tu es en train de perdre ton temps.
The hands of man are not equal with the hands of God.
La main de Dieu n'est pas égale à
la main de Dieu. The length of which the hand of God can go, the hand of man cannot go.
La main de Dieu ne peut pas arriver là où la main de Dieu peut.
Don't look up to man.
Il ne faut pas regarder à l'homme.
Don't look up to man. They are just human like you. They cannot take you to the level that God can take you. They cannot take you to places that God can take you.
Dans une place où le Seigneur peut.
They cannot raise you up from the dust.
Il ne peut pas te faire lever la poussière comme le Seigneur l'a fait.
So why do you look up to man?
Pourquoi est-ce que tu dois regarder à l'homme?
Look up to the hills.
Il faut regarder.
That is up to the Lord. From where cometh your help? He is our help.
Il est celui qui
nous aide. He alone is our help.
Lui seul peut nous aider.
Praise God. It's only Him alone and no one
else. Il y a seul lui et rien que lui.
He is the only help.
Il n'y a que lui qui peut nous
aider. We have to look out.
C'est le peuple en lui qu'on peut regarder.
When things are going on wrong,
quand les choses ne
when the devil is tormenting you,
quand le diable est en train
I will not give you food to eat.
Je ne dois pas te donner de
I will not pay your fees.
Je ne dois pas
te tell the devil I have a helper. That I know where my help comes from. It doesn't come from you, devil.
Mon secours ne vient pas de toi, mais ça vient de mon Dieu.
When the devil says,
quand le diable dit,
I'll see how you get healed.
Je verrai comment tu seras guéri.
I'll see how you have a job.
Je verrai comment tu auras du travail.
Say, you are a liar. You are not my helper. My help comes only from God. I know the God that I am serving. I know I'm serving a living God. I'm not serving a dead God. I'm serving a God of provision. I am serving a God that supplies my needs.
Un Dieu qui me secoue.
Why do we keep on looking up to people?
Pourquoi nous devons toujours regarder aux
gens? You look up to people at times they even insult you.
Tu regardes.
Some will mock at you, they will laugh at you.
Moquer de toi.
Some will even give and they will go behind and
ils say, look at that one. You can't be afraid of
them. Some will even see you coming towards that door, they shut that door, they say, hey, it's too much.
Auprès de la porte, ils vont fermer cette
porte. They never cry.
Mais le Seigneur
he never said it's too much.
Il n'a jamais dit c'est beaucoup.
He never said that I'm giving you enough. Don't come again.
Il n'a jamais dit je t'ai trop donné, ne viens plus.
God never says I am tired. Your money is too much.
Dit, je suis
he never said you have been coming always and always and always. Now rest. Let me go to somebody else. No, he never rests. No matter how many times you come, he is able to deliver it. No matter how many years you come, he is able to deliver it.
Delivering.
If you care, you come day by day.
Si tu veux, tu viens chaque jour.
God's people listen. He still up on the heavens and he supplies
it.
He never.
Il n'a jamais abandonné.
He is always faithful.
Il est un Dieu fidèle.
He is always there.
Il est toujours là.
And he makes sure. When you look unto him, he gives you what you want.
Il te donne ce que tu veux.
He makes sure when you look unto him, you never lack. When you run unto him, he embraces you. We should just keep on praising our God.
Nous devons passer le temps à louer notre Seigneur.
Because it's a joy to praise him.
Parce que c'est une joie de nous louer.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The fourth point.
Le quatrième point.
It's a praise. It's an act of humility.
C'est un acte d'humilité.
Telling God.
Dis à Dieu.
And humbling yourself before Him.
Je me soumets.
When you have that attitude of praising God,
tu as cette attitude de louer.
You will live a life of humility. You always humble yourself. Before God, you cannot praise God with pride.
Tu ne peux pas le louer avec arrogance.
You cannot be a prideful person and you praise God.
Tu ne peux pas être arrogant et tu loues.
Because you always speak as if you know more than God.
Parce que tu feras toujours comme si tu connais plus que lui.
We need to be humble.
Nous devons être
soumis. The Bible says in Luke,
la Bible a dit
dans Luke, whoever exalts himself,
tout celui qui
God will bring them down.
Le Seigneur va te
bâtir. The those that are humble. We don't need to boast of things that we cannot do. We don't need to boast of the things that we have. There is a sign of pride. Because we didn't create them. God created those things. God gave them not to us.
Il nous a tout donné.
When we read the book of Daniel,
quand nous lisons le livre de Daniel,
can you read Daniel 4?
Daniel chapitre 4,
verse 30 to 32.
Daniel 4. The king spake and said, it's not this great Babylon that I have built for the house of the kingdom, that for the house of the kingdom by the mighty of my power, for the honor and for my majesty. While the word was in the king's mouth, then fell a voice from heaven saying, O King Nebuchadnezzar, to thee it is spoken, the kingdom is departed from thee, and this shall drive thee from men, and thy dwelling shall be with the beasts of the field. They shall make thee to eat grass as oxen, and seven times shall pass over thee, until thou knowest that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men, and giveth it to whosoever in him.
Hallelujah. You see what pride did to Nebuchadnezzar.
Tu vois ce que l'arrogance a fait à Nebuchadnezzar.
The Bible says when Babylon was restored,
la Bible dit
he was walking around and boasting. That look at what I have done. Was he the one that restored Babylon?
No.
But it was because of pride.
Par rapport à l'arrogance.
And what did the Lord do to him?
Et qu'est-ce que le Seigneur
a fait? He has to send him to the bush.
Il a chassé du milieu des
pride.
L'arrogance.
Pride.
L'arrogance.
All because of pride.
Tout ça par rapport à l'arrogance.
All because he tried to exalt himself above God. All because he tried to exalt himself above somebody that created him. And at the end, what happened? He was humiliated. He was disgraced. And the city was taken away from him. It was because of pride. There are some things that God cannot even give us because we are too proud. He knows that when he gives us those things, we will not be able to serve him again. He knows that when he gives us those things, we will turn our backs from him. We will think that it's because we are working hard.
No.
We have to humble ourselves. God has promised us a lot of things.
Le Seigneur nous a promis beaucoup de
choses. He has promised us a lot of things.
Il nous a promis beaucoup de
choses. We just need to humble ourselves before Him. We just need to humble.
Nous devons nous soumettre.
Some of us don't succeed in life because of pride. It's not because of anything. It's just because of pride. Because when you humble yourself, you see how doors begin to open. When you humble yourself, you see how the blessings begin to come. You see how ways are opening, doors are opening for you.
But
when you are too proud, you always think you know. Someone will even try to help you, you are like, I know. You know, so why need to do it? You know, then why need to save yourself?
Pourquoi est-ce que tu ne t'es pas soumis? Pourquoi est-ce que tu ne t'es pas servi?
It's good to be humble.
C'est bien d'être soumis.
Don't feel too big because you have things that others don't have.
Parce que tu as certaines choses que d'autres n'ont pas.
These soldiers can never go above your head. No matter how you raise them, they will never go above. It has a limit. So when you think you want to go above God, He will bring you down to nothing. As Nebuchadnezzar,
il va te rabaisser comme il a fait à Nebuchadnezzar.
Hallelujah. Number 5th point.
Le cinquième point.
Praises.
La louange.
Cause us to consider and appreciate God's presence. Appreciate God's character. When you are praising God, you always have that mind of appreciating Him. You appreciate God for His love. You appreciate God for His mercy. You appreciate God for His goodness, for His loving kindness upon your life, for His protection upon your life. When you are praising God, you always appreciate Him for everything.
Le loue toujours pour toutes choses.
Psalms 50, 95, verse 2 to 3.
Psaume 95.
Psalm
95, verse 2 to 3.
Psalm 95, 2. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and make a joyful noise unto him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods.
Hallelujah. He said our God is a great God, and a great King above all. Come into his presence with thanksgiving. Come before God, thanking him. And for those things that he hasn't done to you, just be thanking him. If you don't have a child, just say, God, I thank you for those children. If you don't have a husband, God, I thank you for that husband. God, I thank you for that wife. I thank you for that huge bank account. Thank you for that healing. Thank you for the breakthrough. Just appreciate him. Appreciate his mightiness, his excellency, his faithfulness. Just keep on appreciating him.
Il faut passer le temps.
And God sees you appreciating him for the little that he has done.
L'apprécier pour les
plus. When he sees that you have been telling him how good he is,
il voit,
he becomes more good to you. How faithful he is, he becomes more faithful. How wonderful he is, he becomes more wonderful. How marvelous he is. He becomes more and more marvelous. Isn't our God so great? We should appreciate him for his character.
For son caractère.
He's a great God. He's the lion of the tribe of Judah. The lion of the valley. The ancients of days. The one that knows our beginning and our end. The one that knows our thoughts. He knows the path that we take. What doesn't he know about us? He knows everything. Why can't we appreciate him and tell him how sweet? Why can't we appreciate all his goodness? That good name. Tell him that, Lord, you are so awesome. You are powerful. It is good to praise him. It is good to appreciate him. Because when you appreciate, he does more. But when you don't appreciate God for the little, you expect him to give more. No. Start appreciating him for what he has done. The more you appreciate him, the more he gives. Praise the Lord. Number six.
Le sixième point.
Ses praises bring God's intervention in our praising.
L'intervention de
Dieu. And release a miracle.
Et ça
for an open gate.
Et ça relance le miracle.
Hallelujah. Praises bring God's intervention.
Ça bring l'intervention.
When we look at the life of Paul and Silas in praison.
La vie de Paul, Salas,
the Bible says when they were put in prison,
la Bible dit, quand ils étaient mis en prison,
the hour comes that they start singing praises unto their gods.
À un moment qu'ils ont commencé à chanter,
they were singing praises unto their gods. And what happened? The Bible says an earthquake happened. And the gates were broken. And the chains that were put around them were broken. That was a miracle. When you praise God, you bring miracles in your life. When you praise God, chains are broken. When you praise God, the tongue of the enemy be attacked with an earthquake. When you praise God, the devil has shaken.
Commence à trembler.
The Bible says they were praising their God. And just of a sudden, there was an earthquake.
Tremblement de terre.
That was a miracle.
C'était un miracle de Dieu.
Those that don't know their God, they didn't know what happened.
Ceux qui ne connaissent
pas Dieu. They call silent because they know their God. They know what they have of God.
Ils savaient ce qui se passait.
The chains that were tied around.
La Bible dit la chaîne qui était attachée sur eux.
I don't know the chain that the enemy have tied around.
La chaîne que les
I don't know the chain.